Well, hard not to notice the skyline looking so different these days, Jeff, as SU deflated the carrier dome as part of the roof replacement project.
Yeah, that's actually a live picture, Christy, right now, and you can see a lot of that original dome roof has been torn up and taken away. But I actually got to get inside there about a day or so before that all happened. Super amazing to see what they were doing in there. And even more surprising to me was finding out that we may not be able to make that famous joke around here too much longer about an arena named after an air conditioning company without any AC.
Our goal is to have air conditioning by commencement of 2021, and I don't see why I can't hit that date, but that's going to be happening. And again, I've had people reach out and say, oh, finally, right? You're getting air conditioning. It opens up more dates for us in the spring.
Some of that work will start soon, but there are multiple projects happening at the same time here, including what to do with all of that roof now that it's hanging just a few dozen feet over the floor. And how about that floor? The original tartan surface basketball court found when they peeled back the turf a couple weeks ago.
I tell everybody that the Pearl shot, you know, is the memory. I mean, come on, how do you not? That's the one.
With the roof down, now it needs to come apart quickly.
Our goal is to get in there with the contractor, Pfeiffer Fabri-Tech, and start cutting panels out, letting them hit the floor.
Some of that fabric will be used for souvenirs, including a piece for each graduating senior. The other key, taking down the nearly 3 miles of cable netting that was holding the air-inflated roof together. That's why many of the seats were removed so they wouldn't be damaged in this process. Those will be reinstalled.
We see the white wrap around the inside. That's actually shrink wrap like on a boat.
Yeah.
Everything's framed off and waterproof where the ribbon boards are, and it's to separate the bowl from the concourses.
They've been going 24/7 since the last game in here on March 1st, working outside by day and inside with temporary lights by night. An end of an era and a beginning of a new one that for Sala can't come soon enough.
The emotional part is that, you know, this place is a living, breathing building. You don't walk away from it.
That all changes with the new roof. And can we still get sucked out of the dome doors?
Not like you used to.
Oh, okay.
So the first year of operation, we'll still run with some pressure in the building to operate the exhaust fans and things like that.
Year two, that all goes away. They don't need any air. They get new mechanicals. Now, the Crown Truss part of the project, that's that big, giant, white steel section you see being constructed right there on the top of the dome. That part of the project's a little bit behind, but Sala says there's still room for them to work into April on that without any problems. The new roof installation part of the project, that's all on time, starting with, as you can see, taking off that old roof.
Really making progress. I think it's great that the seniors, too, get a piece of that roof. That is fantastic.